Okay, so before we start today's video, I wanted to just put a little bit of a disclaimer, king of disclaimers, but there are a lot of thoughts that I'm still navigating through with this topic. And as I always say, you can always change your mind. But this is where I'm at right now, and this is also what feels the truest to me. It's not going to be the truest for everyone that makes videos, anyone that's starting to make videos, any influencer that works with sponsors and all that sort of stuff. Like, everyone's different. I know not everybody agrees with that mindset. Not everybody thinks that you can use sponsor money for good or anything. You know, not everybody agrees with that, and that's totally fair. Come as who and how you are, but for me, this is what feels the most sustainable and right in terms of wanting to do right by the people that I work with, and also wanting to do right as an example of what it can look like to have a small YouTube business and be able to run things with a bit more of an ethical mindset, you know? Let's get into the video.
It's raining. It's pouring. The old man is snoring. He went to bed and bust his head and couldn't get up in the morning. It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring. He went to bed and bust his head and couldn't get up in the morning. It's raining, hey, it's pouring, hey, the old. Okay. Not the remix. The third time I've tried to record this video. At this point, I'm just gonna try to have fun with it because
Hello and welcome slash welcome back to my channel. My name is Khadija. Nieces, nephews, nibblings, aunties, uncles, piblings, y'all know what to do. But if you're new, feel free to take a look around, suss out the vibe. I just sit in my workspace and talk about whatever I want. And today we're gonna talk about something I've been struggling with in my mind for a while. As you know, or maybe as some of you might have observed, I have a hard time saying things with my chest sometimes because it's not about not coming off controversial or anything like that. I just more so am like, I try to be mindful of, you know what? Never mind. This is me doing it right now. This is the conversation for me and my therapist. We're gonna be talking about sponsorships. And I'm gonna be talking about my kind of in defense of sponsorships. I don't think that people are against people doing sponsors or anything like that. I don't think that people hate sponsorships or anything like that. I'm very aware that there's not, at least in my mind, there isn't an anti-sponsorship group of people. There may be some people that are anti certain sponsorships, which I get. So we'll talk about that. But yeah, this is hopefully gonna be a shorter video again because it's the end of the year. I'm tired, and like I said, I'm trying not to hold y'all hostage for 45 minutes every week. This is madness. Khadija, stop talking so much. So, speaking of sponsors, let's pay some bills, make sure the crew's taken care of, and then get to it.
Thank you to Acorn TV for sponsoring today's video. So Acorn TV is the largest commercial-free British streaming service. Y'all know I'm partial to the British programs because I always be talking about Made in Chelsea, but Acorn TV is a bit different. They offer hundreds of exclusive shows from around the world, including award-winning series across genres like mysteries, dramas, comedies, and many more. With Acorn TV, you get access to premium, commercial-free, international content for a fraction of the cost compared to most streaming services, because you know they'd be out of control. Acorn TV, on the other hand, is just $5.99 a month.
One of their shows that I recently started watching is called Manhunt. Listen, I love me a good whodunit murder mystery type thing. Also, I'm gonna be honest with y'all, it's been a rough time of year. I've been real So it's been really nice, honestly, to just veg out at the end of the day and just binge watch some content. I'm not gonna lie to you, like, and especially with the overcast setting, the smooth and calming sounds of British detectives trying to figure out who was up in here killing all these young girls. You know, it just was, it's been soothing. So if you want to try Acorn TV for free for 30 days, go to acorn.tv and enter promo code Khadija. That's Khadija. All right, let's get back into the video.
So, as some of you know, in January of this year is when my YouTube blew up. I've been doing it since June of 2020, but it like blew up this year because T-Noir, hey girl, shouts. Okay, sorry. Embarrassing. But it blew up. I went from like 800 subscribers to over 100,000 in a couple of weeks, and it's just kind of been growing from there. So it's, the numbers are great and like, whoa. But honestly, after a certain number, like once I hit 10,000 subscribers, I couldn't count in my head. So I was just like, I can't compute that number. But the thing that started coming with all of those subscribers and the attention, and then I had a video blow up as well, was a lot of reaching out by sponsors. I had a lot of people reaching out wanting to work with me, and I got very overwhelmed because I was like, I don't know how to negotiate. What am I worth? Nothing.
Like, what does it all mean? Nothing.
Damn. Again, another conversation for me and my therapist. I'll see you next Sunday, girl. But in all seriousness, I really didn't know what I was doing, and I had a friend help me for a while, and then I also had one of my friend's managers who actually works more in this kind of market helping me for a while. So yeah, it just was a lot, but it was very strange to me how, if you're not in this kind of world of like the influencer marketing, YouTube content marketing and stuff, it's so fascinating once you learn what people are willing to pay just for you to endorse their product, because they essentially are doing the thing that they did for so long with celebrities. The only reason someone would really want to buy X perfume is not just because it's classy and it's this, but it's also because this actress or whomever that people love wears it, and you want to smell like that person, don't you? You know, advertising marketing, it's actually quite simple when you really think about it. Just selling an illusion to people, selling people a story, selling people the aesthetic, essentially. And in this time period of social media, we care a lot about aesthetics, so. But it was very weird to me, but kind of interesting, and it was cool because the brands that were reaching out to me were brands that I had either already heard of and was using on my own anyway. So it was like, oh wow, I don't even have to pretend to like these people because I actually like it. Sweet. And brands that I had wanted to try but was just like, I don't have the funds to be doing this, and you know, all of that sort of stuff. So it was very cool, but I started to feel a little bit guilty as well. At the beginning specifically, and from time to time now, because I'm like, well, what I'm doing isn't hard work. I'm not earning this money enough. I have to be blood, sweat, and tears, nearly on the edge of death, tired all the time and stressed, because that's what I'm used to. I've been working customer service since I was like 14. And I'm just so used to working two or three jobs at a time, working one or two jobs while I'm in school, like always hustling, always being tired, especially the last almost decade of serving. God, serving is... Damn it! Hold on. Oh my goodness. Sorry, y'all. I got a package and then I... unplug the mic and I'm a mess. Okay. You're not a mess. You just got kerfuffled for a moment. Be impeccable with your word, y'all. Okay. Where was I? Anyway, I'm very used to having to earn my money the hard way, and for a long time my phrase was suffer now, enjoy later.
Wow,
I can't wait to be 30. These 20s were bullshit. Anyway, as a result, when I would get sponsors that would reach out to me willing to pay X amount of money for a 2-minute integration, I was just like, whoa, this is wild. But something that and as it went on, I remember talking to my dad about this, and he's someone that I talk to whenever I feel super like, I don't know what to do, because he's very still, he's very pious, he's the old wise man I want to become when I get older. And I said to him, you know, I don't want to have too much money. It's just putting me off. That scares me. And he was like, well, why? And I said, well, because look at the examples that I have in the world. Like, sure, these people donate to charities and all that, whatever, but they just use it as a tax write-off. They exploit their workers. Like, I just don't want to be a part of that. And he was like, who says you have to be a part of it? And I don't know why I didn't think this way. I think I just, even though I say like power always reveals, I was just very worried that if I had too much money money than the natural influence and power that comes with a certain amount of wealth would get to me, and I would not like the person that I was. I would find out that I'm not as good a person as I think I am. Like, I say that to y'all all the time, but that's because I'm also speaking to myself. And I was really scared of that. That's just me being honest with y'all. I was like, what if I'm a low-key capitalist? You know, like, especially with my whole work ethic, work hard, immigrant parents, you can come up. Like, it's natural, I think, for me to have had that sort of percolating in the back of my mind, because that's the messaging I grew up with. The American dream, all of these sorts of things. So there's a lot that I'm unlearning, 1000%. And, you know, being a child of immigrants, a lot to unlearn with that too. I also think, though, that now I'm standing more firm in my stance about certain things. And for me, I've realized that, why is this hard for me to say? I just say it, Khadija. I've realized that I am happy that I don't have to worry about sponsors, knock on wood, for this time period. Let's talk about why, and why I am in defense of, or the case for, or whatever you want to call it. In having that conversation with my dad, it really just showed me that I wasn't gonna know until I tried. And so I started to be totally fine with accepting sponsorships and having them every video. And I was continuously being reached out to by sponsors and stuff. And thankfully it was sponsors that I actually liked working with. There have been a couple of mistakes in there. I know. I didn't have all the information. I know, y'all. Listen, you're allowed to make mistakes, okay? I'm allowed to make mistakes, so it happens from time to time. But for the most part, I am proud of all the sponsors that I use and work with. And the main reason, besides that I actually use the products and services, including my own discount codes, don't play with me, come on, is because my main goal with doing YouTube, with trying to create whatever small business media thing this is to create a workspace where the people that I work with know that I value them as people above all first. So for me, one of the main ways to do that is by paying them a reasonable wage. And different countries, I work with people that live in different countries, different parts of the world. Minimum wage is different there, but I, in my mind, always wanted to make sure that I wasn't paying them minimum wage, that I was paying them above minimum wage, because I know what it's like to live off of minimum wage, but then to also live off of less than minimum wage. Like, being a server, you get less, and then they count on tips, and sometimes you don't get tips, and it's a whole mess. So I wanted the people that I worked with, the crew, Maddie, Priscilla, Travis, Raul, Antonia. Am I missing anyone? Everyone that I work with in the long form videos, like my sister, Matthew, Thomas, Gino. Who else is working with us in that? My brother did some stuff with us as well. Oh my God, I really hope I'm not missing anyone. But I really wanted to make sure that everyone that I was working with knew that I valued them and valued their work and their contributions. So to me, that meant paying them a reasonable wage and being honest and transparent about money and constantly checking in to be like, is this rate still fair for you? Is it still working for you? And also being able to do that for people that come and do a video with me or talk with me on the channel or anything like that. I think because people aren't as transparent about money, because people aren't as honest about what they earn, especially as leaders of certain small businesses or organizations or whatever, it leaves a lot of dubious practices, I would say, when it comes to the people that you work with. And I always try to say work with, not for, because I'm really just trying to get out of that mindset that, like, the people that work with me are, like, somehow, I don't know, owe me this, or like I'm signing their checks so they have to, but like, that's no. So sponsorships, if I'm going to be completely honest, have thoroughly helped me be able to do that and do that consistently. Yes, YouTube AdSense pays well to an extent, but my AdSense, I just know it's kind of like this a little bit. And I am a Taurus who likes consistency and stability. And knowing that I have X amount of sponsors lined up per month, that I know this is what you're gonna get for that month completely, it's like, okay, at least I know I have that income. You know what I'm saying? So I know that sometimes people will will. Some viewers are like, girl, you don't have to explain yourself. Who cares? Who cares about the sponsors? The sponsors, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And other times people will be like, no, you should explain yourself. Why are you working with this people? Why are you doing this? Blah, 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 blah. For me, it's a lot of things, but the main things are just that I actually like the products and services that I use, barring, yes, a couple of mistakes for sure. One. Two, I strongly believe that you need to have multiple sources of income. As any person, like no matter what your job is, I think it's just smart practice to have multiple sources of income. And if I can have two sources of income in one platform, holler. And three, and again, the most important is I wanna make sure that as my channel grows, as I start to increase my production value with certain videos and things like that, that I am paying the people that I work with a good wage, because I want them to feel like I value them as not just people that I work with, but as people. And for me, I know that monetary compensation shouldn't be the only way you show folks that you value them. But in a capitalist world, when the rent is due and people are stressed about money, if you're gonna be spending hours helping me research or fact check or do captions or anything, I need to give you, part of me showing that I value you as an employee. Ugh. Part of me showing that I value you as a member of the crew is giving you the means, the financial means to be able to continue to do that work, to take time out of your day to do that work. Do you know what I'm saying? Now, the last little thing that I wanna touch on about this whole sponsorships and me like saying it with my chest, being in defense of if you can get your stuff sponsored, do it. Or if you, your favorite content creators are always getting stuff sponsored, like you don't know maybe why they might be doing that. And I know it would be better if people just explain themselves, but a lot of people feel like they don't have to. And I, you know, to a certain extent they don't, but also communication, you know? But another reason that I understand the other side of it is that sometimes I think people have this idea that like sponsors will not allow you to say certain things. You have to be very sanitized in order to get sponsorships and all this sort of stuff. And I agree with that to an extent. Like, I know that there are probably some sponsors out there that will, they might have some ideas about certain things that they want you to say or not say, or certain language stuff, maybe certain legality stuff in terms of clips and memes that you can use, all that sort of jazz. For me, I have always tried to maintain that I will not work with a sponsor that tells me I can't say something. Like, that's just the black ass bottom line. Because, no. Like, and I know that I can kind of get away with that because it's not like my content is super radical or like, I don't know, whatever. It's not like talking about media studies and sociology and analyzing it through that lens is super, super dramatic. But I know that I have covered certain topics that might be a bit touchy and have still gotten that sponsored, because for me, I just have that kind of boundary. I have that setup of like, yes, I am for pro sponsorships. I'm pro getting a bit of extra coin to be able to sustain your living, to sustain doing this full time if you need to, or to sustain paying others fairly to be able to do this full time. And I also get that, yeah, for some people, that's the big worry is like, okay, well, if everything you do is sponsored, like, are you really like saying what you want, or are you just like appeasing blah, 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 blah. I'm gonna let you know right now, I pretty much say whatever I want. And I am somebody that does try to be careful with my words for a number of reasons, but one of them being that, like I said, I think I said this earlier in the video, I believe in being impeccable with my word. And so that's why I choose my words so carefully. I think sometimes it comes across like I'm trying to like make everyone happy. And there might be elements of that to it. I'd be lying if I said that there weren't elements of that, but I think, no, I know more of it is just, I am very mindful about how your words can be used against you, can be taken out of context. So I try to do my due diligence. At the end of the day, people are gonna do that no matter what. That's a rant separate. This has nothing to do with sponsorships. Anyway, anti-weight. I think it's very interesting how as TV, television, cable completely, like who even has cable anymore, as all of that becomes more obsolete and people are spending more time on the internet, how it's starting to be like television was, but in a more realistic sense, because I think people are more willing to buy products and services from folks that seem like them, that seem approachable, that seem relatable, you know, seem authentic than they would from some random commercial with a bunch of actors telling them that they need to get something, you know? And so because of that, I think that, yeah, I think as a content creator, as a influencer, that part of my job is doing this, is introducing y'all to products and services that I use, that I enjoy, that are helping me pay for the content that y'all love, because that's what it is too. They're helping me out. They're helping the crew out. We gotta be honest about it. I think just at the end of the day, I take it really seriously, all of this stuff, why I try to speak very carefully, why I try to use discernment with certain sponsors and don't always do the best job, I know. But I take it seriously because I know that at the end of the day, me, whatever product or service that I am promoting on this channel that is helping me take care of the crew, take care of myself, be able to do this full time and on a weekly basis, I take it seriously, the responsibility that my opinion of those things will sway my audience's opinion, because I have looked up to other people that have worked with certain sponsors and brands and stuff and thought that they were okay because I trusted those people's opinion. So I fully understand that, yes, it's okay for me to say that I'm pro sponsorships and wanting people to like take advantage of the fact that there are going to be folks out there willing to pay them to simply advertise their stuff so that they can continue to do this full time and all of that. It's just kind of tricky because there's that whole notion of you feel like you're selling out if you have too many sponsors or things like that, because I always think of this Rumi quote in the back of my mind, which is, if you only care about profit, you will be bought and sold your entire life. It's something like that. I'll put it on the screen to get the exact quote. But that's something that I carry with me in my mind all the time, because I have been approached by many types of sponsors and I don't always say yes because I'm like, girl, what? Like, this is not, no. And also, you know, like, but that's stuff that goes on behind the scenes that y'all are not going to be privy to because you're not with me every day. You don't know all this stuff. And I think we don't talk enough honestly about sponsorships and the benefits of having sponsors versus the not so great benefits of it. You know, I don't know if we talk enough about, openly and honestly enough, about when, you know, you just make a mistake with a sponsor, or as it happens, a sponsor does something scandalous and you're like, dang, gonna be a while before I work with them again. Oh no. You know, like I don't know if we talk enough about that. And so that was just kind of part of my reasoning for doing this vid, and also just wanting to, in a way, explain to y'all why I have so much sponsored content and why I believe in being able to have a lot of sponsored content. It's not for everyone. Some people, it's not their jam. They're like, no, I don't even want to get into the headache of it, because once you start, it just seems like more come, and then you have to like be a certain way to blah, 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 blah. I completely get it. And it is not lost on me that I may be a more sanitized version than some of your faves. And that's why it is easier for me to get certain sponsorships. I'm not dumb. I know to an extent. You know, I know that because of the kind of personality that I have, that I literally can make anything a joke, because this is all a joke. What? Why are we even here? Why are we alive? So stupid. God. It is stupid. I have an existential crisis every other video. Anyway, I don't really have a final thoughts, anything. Again, I wanted to keep this video short, simple, and to the point. So yeah, that's all I have for y'all today. I'm sorry. I wish I had more, but this is all I have. Be sure to feed your plets, water your plets, and remember that you can always change your mind, because you can. And I'll see y'all in the next one. I know I say this when I'm not working off a script a lot, but I actually mean it. I really hope this made sense, because I feel like it started to make sense and then I started to lose the point. Anywho, bye.